The next thing which we are going to discuss is the theories of evolution. The theories of evolution. There were four major theories which were put forward in the course of evolution. They were Lamarck theory of inheritance of acquired characters. The first theory was Lamarck theory of the inheritance of acquired character. What Lamarck said that the characters or the traits which have been taken up by an organism in its life are being acquired by that. मतलब जो कुछ characters और कुछ traits जो एक किसी organisms के द्वारा उसकी life में लिए गए हैं for leading their life, that will be inherited from the one generation to the another generation. The characters which have been taken up by an organism for leading their life or in the particular life, that character are called as acquired character, and that characters will be inherited from one generation to the another generation. This was said by Lamarck, and due to the as the name suggests that Lamarck's theory of the inheritance of an acquired character, this is also called as Lamarckism. The second theory was Darwin's theory of natural selection. Darwin's theory of natural selection. What Darwin said, he said that the particular variation or some kind of variation which have been taken up by an organism from the environment. So, whichever be the variation will be the most suited to the environment, or whichever variation will be the best, that is more adapted to the environment, that will be selected by the nature. जो भी variation सबसे अच्छा होगा, सबसे best होगा, वो nature के द्वारा चुना जाएगा, and that will be inherited from the one generation to another. Yeah, that acquired, that variation will be transferred to the generation after generation. This was said by Darwin. The third theory, mutation theory. Mutation means sudden change. Sudden change in the genetic makeup or sudden change of anything that leads to the mutation, or that is called as the mutation. So, the sudden change in any kind of variation, कोई भी variation में अगर कुछ change हुआ, so if that variation is good, then that will be transferred to the generation after generation. And this mutation is an inheritable character. Mutation is inheritable character hai. Therefore, this leads to the evolution. And this mutation theory was given by Hugo de Vries. Hugo de Vries gives this mutation theory. And the Darwin's theory, as the name suggests, was given by Darwin, and it is also called as Darwinism. The fourth and the last theory was is the modern theory. or it is also called as synthetic theory or also called as neo-Darwinism. Modern theory or synthetic theory or neo-Darwinism. It is formed by the combination of all these three theories, or the what these theories said, the evidences which were in the favor of these theories were compiled up and further more studied by various scientists, and they put forward the another theory which is called as modern theory or synthetic theory or the neo-Darwinism. Now we will start the one by one studying all this theory. The first theory which we are going to take is Lamarck theory of the inheritance character of the acquired inheritance of acquired characters. Lamarck theory of inheritance of acquired characters. So, as I told you here that Lamarck told that some of the characters or some of the traits have been taken up by the organisms during leading his own life, and that characters which are taken up by the organism, that characters are said as acquired characters, and that characters have been inherited to the next generation or generation after the generation. So he put forth some of the postulates. The first postulate was new needs. The first postulate what he has given, that was new needs. So environment is the place where we get all the things or all the conditions for leading a good life. If there is certain change in the environment, agar environment mein kuch bhi change aayega, then it will create the chance of a new need. Abhi to environment ke according sab theek chal raha hai, par agar environment mein there happens a certain change or the certain variation in the environment, that will create the new need. And for fulfilling that new need, us nayi ichha ki poorti karne ke liye, the organism have to put some of the effort. उसे कुछ एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट उस नई इच्छा की पूर्ति के लिए लगाना पड़ेगा. सो दैट न्यू नीड्स हैव बीन जनरेटेड बाय द एनवायरनमेंट. व्हाट द फर्स्ट पोस्टुलेट ऑफ लेमार्क सेज दैट द न्यू नीड्स आर जनरेटेड इन द एनवायरनमेंट, एंड फॉर फुलफिलिंग दैट न्यू नीड्स एन ऑर्गेनिज्म हैव टू पुट सम एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट सो दैट इट कैन बी अचीव्ड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, we take an example of giraffe. Earlier, giraffe used to fed on the grassland type of environment, or there were the small plants, there were the small herbs and shrubs on which giraffe used to fed upon. Giraffe used to graze that that type of small plants. But due to some geographical disturbances, that small plants and that small herbs and shrubs that were vanished. So the only remaining food material for the giraffe was long and tall trees, or the leaves which are available on the long and the tall trees. So ab wo aise to nahi reh sakte, bina khane ke to nahi reh sakte. सो फॉर फुलफिलिंग दिस न्यू नीड, उनके पास में न्यू नीड क्या आई है, उनका नीचे का सारा खाना खत्म हो गया है जो उनके लिए इजीली अवेलेबल था. द फूड विच वॉज इजीली अवेलेबल फॉर देम, दैट ऑल वॉज गॉन, एंड द फूड विच इज अवेलेबल नाउ इज ऑन सम हाइट. इट हैज क्रिएटेड द न्यू नीड कि अगर आप थोड़ा सा एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट डालोगे देन यू विल बी गेट द फूड. So what they did, they started extending their neck and their forelimb. They started stretching their neck and as well as their forelimb. So when they started stretching their neck and their forelimb, they started the using that organs more and more. So the second postulate what Lamarck has given was use and disuse of ऑर्गन. इसमें उन्होंने क्या कहा, जो ऑर्गेनिज्म, अगर वो ऑर्गन, कोई भी ऑर्गेनिज्म है, अगर उसकी बॉडी का कोई भी ऑर्गन ही इज कंटिन्यूअसली यूजिंग, कोई भी ऑर्गन है वो अगर कंटिन्यूअस यूज में आ रहा है, देन दैट ऑर्गन विल बी द स्ट्रॉन्ग ऑर्गन और दैट विल बी द that will increase in its size and its efficiency will be increased as ऐसा organ जो रोज काम में आ रहा है तो वो बढ़ता जाएगा, उसका size भी बढ़ता जाएगा, उसका shape भी अच्छा होगा, उसकी efficiency भी बढ़ेगी. And the organ which is not in use, ऐसा organ जो use में आ ही नहीं रहा है, और the organ which is being disused, तो that will be vanished. This was the second postulate of the Lamarck. So, अगर हम इसे जिराफ वाले एग्जाम्पल से कंपेयर करें तो जिराफ वॉज कंटिन्यूअसली स्ट्रेचिंग इट्स नेक एंड द फोरलिम्स टू रीच द हाइट ऑफ द ट्री. सो दिस वॉज प्रूव्ड, द यूज एंड डिसयूज ऑफ द ऑर्गन एंड द पोस्टुलेट ऑफ द न्यू नीड्स, बोथ ऑफ दीज वर प्रूव्ड दैट जिराफ वॉज कंटिन्यूअसली स्ट्रेचिंग इट्स नेक एंड इट्स फोरलिम. सो उसका नेक भी लंबा हो गया एंड उसके फोर लिम्स भी लंबे हो गए. अर्लियर इट वॉज द एनिमल विच वॉज लुकिंग लाइक अ हॉर्स, इट वॉज नॉट हैविंग द एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी लॉन्ग नेक, बट वेन ही स्टार्टेड स्ट्रेचिंग और वेन ही स्टार्टेड यूजिंग द फोर लिम्स एंड द नेक मोर देन द हाइंड लिम्स, देन द फोर लिम्स एंड द नेक बिकम्स बिग इन साइज एज कंपेयर टू दैट ऑफ द फोर लिम्स. दिस वॉज द कंसेप्ट ऑफ यूज एंड डिसयूज ऑफ द ऑर्गन्स. The third postulate was inheritance of acquired characters. The third was inheritance of acquired characters. जो characters किसी भी organism के द्वारा उसके जीवन काल में उसकी life को जीने के लिए लिए गए हैं, फॉर लीडिंग हिज लाइफ द कैरेक्टर्स विच ही हैज टेकन फ्रॉम द एनवायरमेंट, दैट कैरेक्टर्स आर कॉल्ड एज एक्वायर्ड कैरेक्टर्स एंड दैट एक्वायर्ड कैरेक्टर्स विल बी इनहेरिटेड और विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड फ्रॉम द वन जनरेशन टू द अनदर जनरेशन. दिस वॉज द इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ एक्वायर्ड कैरेक्टर्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन जिराफ, earlier it was the animal like frog, but when he has the new need, he started using his neck and the forelimb. So the character of the elongation of the neck and the forelimb, this was the acquired character which he has generated by the new needs. So when the giraffe will be mated or when they will produce the next generation, then these two character will be inherited in the next generation and the next offspring which will take birth, it will take birth with the long neck and the long forelimbs. This was the third character of inheritance of acquired characters. Now the fourth, speciation. New needs हुई, एनवायरमेंट में कुछ चेंज हुआ, कुछ चेंज होने के कारण नई नीड्स उत्पन्न हुई. नई नीड्स अगर आई हैं तो नई नीड्स को फुलफिल करने के लिए एन ऑर्गेनिज्म हैव टू पुट सम एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट. एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट अगर लगाना है, ऑर्गन्स यूज करने पड़ेंगे. द ऑर्गन विच इज मोस्टली यूज्ड, इट विल बिकम मोर एफिशियंट इन इट्स वर्क एंड द ऑर्गन विच इज नॉट इन यूज और विच इज डिसयूज्ड, इट विल बी gone, it will be vanished. And the third one, jo inheritance of acquired characters, jo organs acquire kiye gaye hain wo next generation mein transfer honge hi, अगर नेक्स्ट जनरेशन में वो और वो ट्रेट या फिर वो कैरेक्टर ट्रांसफर हो रहा है, देन इट विल क्रिएट द न्यू स्पीशीज. जनरेशन आफ्टर जनरेशन इट विल क्रिएट सम ऑफ द चेंजेस. लाइक इफ इन द फर्स्ट जनरेशन द जिराफ विच वॉज बोर्न विथ अ लिटिल लॉन्गर नेक एंड द लिटिल लॉन्गर फोर लिम्स, द नेक्स्ट जनरेशन दैट जिराफ इज टेकिंग मोर एफर्ट टू रीच टू द लॉन्गर ट्रीज. If he is taking more effort to reach to the longer trees, he has to stretch more his organs. If he is stretching more organs, then he is having the long neck and long forelimbs. That more longer character will be transferred to the next generation. And that more longer character will be transmitted to the next generation. This is how generation after generation, by the transfer of the characters, a new species will be formed. This was these were the four postulates of the Lamarck: the new needs, use and disuse of the organs, inheritance of the acquired characters, and the speciation. अब देखो, theory है तो evidences या फिर उसका criticism तो होगा ही. Some will be the evidences in the favor and some will be the evidences or some will be in the criticism. So here we will discuss about the evidences in the favor. Evidences in favor of Lamarckism. First example we have taken of giraffe, the same that new needs आई उसके पास में, then he started using or this is started stretching its neck and the forelimbs, inheritance हुआ उन characters का और नई species बनी. The next example we will take of the snake or python. So this snake and the python, we found some of the ruminants of the pelvic girdle and of the femur in the body of the snake and the python. This we have also studied in the vestigial organ, that the presence of the pelvic girdle and the femur is vestigial in the snake, but these are present in the snake or the python. So earlier it is said that earlier this snake or the python is having the limbs, but when they have some when they have to rescue from their predators, they started living in the or they started burrowing, they started living in the small places, in the holes. So when they enter into the holes, they are having the no use of their limbs. The hole is small in size and they have to adjust there in the small size hole. So वो जब उन small size hole में adjust होने की कोशिश कर रहे थे, they were not using their hands or they were not using their limbs. So afterwards, this is the example of the disuse of the organ. अगर वो उनके limbs use नहीं कर रहे हैं, तो दिस इज द डिसयूज ऑफ ऑर्गन. डिसयूज हो रहा है तो दैट ऑर्गन विल बी जनरेशन आफ्टर जनरेशन इट विल बी एलिमिनेटेड. तो दिस लिम्स वर एलिमिनेटेड फ्रॉम द बॉडी ऑफ द स्नेक एंड दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द डिसयूज ऑफ ऑर्गन. द थर्ड एग्जाम्पल इज ऑफ द एक्वेटिक बर्ड्स. Aquatic birds like duck. These ducks, these are not using their wings. These are not using their wings, and as they are aquatic, they have to swim. So they are not using their wings because their wings are small. जब छोटे हैं तो उड़ नहीं सकते, एंड एज दे आर एक्वेटिक बर्ड्स दे हैव टू स्विम. तो फॉर स्विमिंग पर्पसेस दे हैव डेवलप्ड some webs in their in between their toes. So when they are not using their wings are eliminated and there occurs a new need for swimming. So swimming ke liye unka new needs generate hua, then they developed the webbed type of toes. When they developed the webbed type of toes, that character was inherited in the next generation and there becomes a new species of the duck that is without wings or the small wings with the webbed toes. This is also the example in the favor of the Lamarckism. These are the three examples which gives the evidences of the Lamarckism. Next, we will discuss some criticism in the Lamarck theory. Criticism in Lamarck's theory. The first point or the first criticism in the Lamarck's theory was given by August Weismann. He proposed a theory of continuity of germ plasm. August Weismann, he was the first scientist to for criticizing this Lamarck theory. And he was also he also put forward the theory of continuity of the germ plasm. He performed an experiment against Lamarck's theory. What he did, he said that if the inherited or if the acquired characters are inherited from the one generation to the another, so all the characters which are acquired should be transferred. अगर लमार्क ये कहते हैं कि acquired character transfer होते हैं तो क्या जितने भी characters एक human being और एक किसी organisms के द्वारा acquire किए जाते हैं during its lifetime, that all the characters are being acquired, क्या वो सारे characters inherit होते हैं? So for proving this he performed an experiment. What he did, he took two mouse or two rats and he started mating them. He allows them to mate. When he took two rats, first he cut their tails or he chopped off their tails. He chopped off the tails of both the rats and then he allowed that rats to mate. So after some time when the first generation was produced, then he observed that the chopped off tail mice gives rise to the tailed rat, and then he measured the size of the tail of the offspring, and he has also measured before cutting the size of the tail of that two rats. When he measured the size of the tail of that rat, he found that the similar size was also present in the parents. Again, he took that first generation rat and he took another rat. He again chopped off their tail and again led them to mate, and he got the second generation. Again, he measured the tail of that mice. He found that there was no change in the tail of the mice. Again, in the third generation, he chopped off the tail of the parents of the second generation and he allowed them to mate and produce the third generation. Again, he got the same results. He measured the size of the tail. He got the same size of the tail in all the generation of the mice. He performed this experiment up to 20 generations. उन्होंने 20 generations तक सेम एक्सपेरिमेंट परफॉर्म किया. ही यूज टू चॉप ऑफ द टेल, अलाउड द रैट टू मेट, एंड देन अगेन द ऑफस्प्रिंग विच वॉज बोर्न, ही यूज टू मेजर द साइज ऑफ द टेल. ही डिड दिस फॉर 20 जनरेशंस. After 20 generations, he concluded that all the characters that have been acquired by an organism in its life, that all characters have not been inherited from one generation to the another generation. सारे characters जो कि acquire किए गए हैं, सारे characters जो हैं वो एक generation से दूसरे generation में transfer नहीं होते हैं. This was the experiment which was done by August Weismann for the criticism of the Lamarck theory. The second criticism was the Pavlov's experiment. We know that the Pavlov's experiment, he has done the experiment on dog. What he did, he used to give the food to the dog, or before giving food to the dog, he used to ring the bell, and he trained his dog like this, that first he used to ring the bell, that followed by the food. He used to ring the bell followed by the food. He used to do this for many years, or for 3 and 4 years, he used to practice the dog for, he used to train the dog for this kind of habit, that he used to ring the bell and after that followed by the food. What he observed, that when he used to ring the bell, or one day he rang that bell but he didn't give the food to the dog. What he observed at that time, that when the dog hears the sound of that ringing bell, the dog has already secreted his gastric juices. So the ringing of the bell was a what we can say, that was a clue, or was a sign for a dog that now he will get the food. So after the years after years, the dog was being trained for this kind of habit, that when he will ring the bell, he will get the food. So one day when he rang the bell and he didn't get the food, he started and he didn't give the food to the dog, but the dog has already secreted his gastric juices. But when the offspring, or when the next generation of the dog was born, he started doing this thing, that he used to ring the bell. But that dog, or that new dog that was not trained for this kind of habit, that was not trained for this ringing of the bell and afterward he will get the food. So he didn't respond to this kind of habit. He also, he has to train the next dog also. Unhe dusre dog ko bhi train isi tarah se karna pada for following this kind of habits. So he also concluded that the trait which was acquired by the earlier, or by the parent dog, that the ring and the followed by the ring and followed by the food, that was not transmitted to its baby, that was not transmitted to the next generation. He again used to train that dog, and in the next generation he used to do the same thing for training the dog. He also found that this character was not being inherited to the next generation. This was the second criticism for the Lamarck's theory. The third is piercing in ears and nose. This is very common practice which have been done in many Asian countries, that piercing of the ears and the nose. This is very common. We have been seeing this from many generations, for that our grandmothers also have this piercing, our mother is also have this piercing, sometimes the father is also have this kind of piercing. beside or even beside of this fact that our this piercing practice has been followed from generation after the generation, it is not the acquired, it is not the inherited character, it is not being inherited from one generation to the another generation. So this is also the criticism. And the next example, that the bodybuilders, the bodybuilders used to do heavy muscular exercises and they have the big biceps and triceps, very heavy biceps and triceps. They use to do exercises daily, and this shows that use of the organs, this so this fulfill this postulates, use and disuse of the organs. Continuously one organ was being used, he was using this hands for this or legs for making the biceps and the triceps, but the baby or the offspring of that bodybuilder will not be a muscle man or will not be a born bodybuilder. He will not get that acquired characters of the heavy muscles which his parent was having. He again he has to do all these practices and all these gym exercises for having that kind of muscles that are not being inherited from his parent. And the last example, in China, the short feet. China, the short feet is an example of beauty. In China, it is believed that the woman which is having the short or the small feet is considered as the beautiful. So, for this practice, when any child or when any girl child is being born, they used to cover their legs or they used to always wear the shoes which are covered by the wooden plates. So, when the mother also used to wear this kind of shoes, unki mataen bhi is type ke shoes pehenti hi hongi, to hi unke jo feet hain that are smaller in size. So if their feet are smaller in size and if they are giving birth to a girl child, that trait or that the character should be transmitted to the baby girl, but this not happens. That small feet character is not being transferred to the baby girl. So this all examples shows that all the characters are not being acquired, all the characters which are acquired in one's life are not being inherited to the next generations. Only that characters will be inherited which are associated with the germ cells. Sirf wohi characters jo inherit honge jo ki germ cell se associated hai, and all these characters which we have seen in the criticism, these characters, these are associated with the somatic cells. Only those characters will be transmitted that was that were associated with the germ cells. So these were some evidences in the favor of the Lamarckism, and these were the criticism in the Lamarck's theory. So this was all about the Lamarck theory. The next theory which we are going to take is Darwinism or the Darwin's theory of the natural selection.